Hi everyone, today we will discuss about the resolution of forces. This is the fifth section. So what here question is given, when more than four forces are given, you have to use the resolution of the system. Sometime here P will be missing, and sometime will be force will be missing, and sometime theta will be missing. So depending upon that, you have to find out the force and theta. So here somewhat question is given like that. The resultant having a magnitude of 400 Newton means resultant value is given. Which value is given? Resultant value. Resultant is equal to how much is given? 400. Now next step, you have to identify whether that resultant belongs to horizontal or vertical. So you have to read the question completely, and it is acting on x axis. It is acting on x axis means the sum of horizontal is given. The sum of horizontal is equal to 400 Newton. It is given in your question. It is given in your question. The sum of horizontal is equal to 400 Newton. It is given in your question. The sum of horizontal is equal to 400 Newton. This one is given in your question. The next step, what you have to do means, after that, what you have to do means, sum of horizontal is equal to 400 Newton. Determine the unknown force P. He is asking to find out the value of P. Determine the unknown force. He is asking to find out the value of P and its inclination, and he is asking to find out the value of theta also. He is asking to find out the value of P and he is asking to find out the value of theta. Now what you have to do to find out the theta and P value, what you have to do, first you have to remember this quadrant system. I explain you number of classes, but this is the important topic is there. Here x is positive, here x is negative, here y is positive, here y is negative. X is positive, x is negative, y is positive, y is negative. This is your first quadrant, this one is your second quadrant, this one is your third quadrant, this one is your fourth quadrant. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. In first quadrant, the sign of x and y both are positive. In second quadrant, the sign of x is negative, sign of y is positive. In third quadrant, x and y is positive. In fourth quadrant, x is positive, y is negative. You have to remember this one. First quadrant, the sign of x and y both are positive. In second quadrant, the sign of x is negative, y is positive. In third quadrant, the x is negative, y is also negative. In fourth quadrant, the x is positive, y is negative. You have to remember this one. And the direction also, this one is the forward, this one is the upward, this one is the backward, this one is the downward. Forward, upward, backward, downward. Forward, upward, backward, downward. Forward, upward, backward, downward. Forward, upward, backward, downward. This is the first coordinate, this is the second coordinate, this is the third quadrant, this is the fourth quadrant. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. Okay. After that, what you have to do, you have to resolve this one with respect to that. See, this one is lying in which quadrant? First you have to place the resultant. Resultant is given on horizontal axis. Resultant is given on horizontal axis. So this one you have to consider as how much this is? 400 Newton. How much this is resultant? I will write here sum of horizontal. Sum of horizontal. How much it is sum of horizontal? 400. Sum of horizontal is equal to how much? 400. But this one you will consider as the resultant. You will not consider as the force. This one you have to consider as the resultant. While calculating the force, don't consider the sum of horizontal. Because if it is force will be there, then you can consider. But this one is the resultant is there. Whenever resultant is given, in place of sum of horizontal and in place of sum of vertical only, you have to take care that one. Now, what I have to do? First, I have to resolve this one. See, this force is lying in which coordinate? First coordinate. This force is lying in which quadrant? First quadrant. In first quadrant, what you have to do? Forward and upward. After that, this one is lying in which quadrant? Second quadrant. So backward and upward. This one is lying in which quadrant? Third quadrant. So backward and downward. This one is lying on the axis. whenever any force is lying on the axis, no need to find out the x axis as well as y axis, no need to resolve into x component and y component, because it is lying on the axis. Whether any force is lying on the x axis or y axis, no need to resolve that one, because already it is horizontal or vertical force is there. So, no need to. What you have to resolve only inclined force. This one is the inclined force, you have to resolve. This one is the inclined force, you have to resolve. This one is the inclined force, you have to resolve. So, wherever you are finding the inclined force, that forces only you have to resolve. After that, what you have to do? Horizontal component you have to write as the Fx. So, this one you can write as the Fx. And this one also you can write as the Fx. And this one is also you can write as the Fx. Okay, horizontal component. 1, 2, 3. Why I am not considering this one 400 Newton? Because it is not horizontal component. The resultant is given. In your question it is mentioned. The resultant having a magnitude of 400. Magnitude means resultant. Magnitude, I told you. Magnitude and resultant both are same. So, magnitude of 400 Newton. That's why I am not considering this force. Now, next step what you have to do? I have to write vertical component. I have to assign as the Fy, this one can be as the Fy, and this one also can be write as the Fy, Fx, Fy. Here on the axis is there, that's why I am not considering here. After that, next step you have to identify the sign. In which coordinate, what is the sign of x axis and y axis? See here, as you can observe here, this one is lying in first quadrant. In first quadrant, the sign of x is positive, the sign of y is also positive. So, fx also you have to write as positive and fy also you have to write as positive. In second coordinate, the sign of x here, the sign of x is negative, the sign of y is positive. The sign of x is negative, the sign of y is positive. In third coordinate, the sign of x is negative, the sign of y is also negative. In examination, this part will be not given. You have to memorize this one. You have to remember this one for your easy explanation or easy and understanding purpose. I drawn this one. So, here in third quadrant, the sign of x is also negative, the sign of y is also negative. After and last step, you have to identify whether the coordinate is lying with respect to horizontal axis or vertical axis. For find out that one, what you have to do? Whether it is lying with respect to horizontal axis and with respect to vertical axis. For that purpose, you have to identify it is lying in which coordinate. This one is lying in which coordinate? See here, the theta is lying with the horizontal axis. Here also the theta is lying with the horizontal axis, and here also the theta is lying with the horizontal axis. So, horizontal you have to take as the cos and vertical you can take as the sin theta. So, here theta is lying with the horizontal axis. So, horizontal you can take as the cos theta. So, here I can write how much it is? 100 cos 30 degree. And here I can write 100 sin 30 degree, 100 cos 30 degree, 100 sin 30 degree. Next step, here as you can see that theta is lying with the horizontal, theta is lying with the horizontal. So, this one here force is not given. So, what you have to do? P cos theta, and this one you can take as P sin theta, P cos theta and P sin theta. Next one, here also the theta is lying with the horizontal. So, this one 400 cos theta, and here also 400 sin theta. Theta is equal to how much? 45 degree. Theta is equal to how much? 45 degree. After that, what you have to do? You have to find out the resultant. For finding the resultant, already sum of horizontal resultant is given. So, you have to find out sum of horizontal and sum of vertical. For finding the sum of horizontal, you have to write like this. Sum of horizontal forces. How much sum of horizontal forces is there? First is equal to how much? 100 cos 30. So, 100 cos 30. Then sum as next one is the minus. You have to consider the sign. Minus P cos theta. Minus P cos theta. Next one is the horizontal force, minus 400 cos theta. So, here minus 400 cos theta. Theta is equal to how much? 45 degree. This one only 1, 2 and 3. Only 3 forces are there. Why you are not considering this one? This one is the resultant. This one is the resultant. That's why you are not considering this one. Okay, na? Only you are considering 1, 2, 3. This is the first one. This one is the second one. And this one is the third one. So, but in question, sum of horizontal value is given. How much it is given? 400. In question it is given. Where it is given? In question it is given. In question it is mentioned that sum of horizontal is 400. Suppose this one is not mentioned, what you have to do? If unknown force are there, sum of horizontal you have to consider as a 0. Sum of horizontal you have to consider as the 0. But in this problem, sum of horizontal is given. How much it is given? 400 is given. So, in place of sum of horizontal, I will substitute that. So, here sum of horizontal is there. So, in place of that, I will substitute 400 is equal to 100 cos 30 minus P cos theta minus 400 cos 45 degree. 400 is equal to 100 cos 30 minus P cos theta minus 400 cos 45 degree. Like this is given. So, next step what you have to do? See, this one is the unknown. So, better to bring this another side. This is negative sign, it is positive. So, what you have to do? You have to send this side. So, it will become positive. So, this one if you transfer this side, it will become P cos theta. This one write down as it is. 400 cos 30 degree, this one also write down as it is, 400 cos 45 degree, and this 400 if you shift that side it will become negative, negative 400. After that P cos theta is equal to, with the help of calci if you solve this one you will get something like this, minus 596.24 Newton. With the help of calci, if you solve this one, you will get like this value. P cos theta is equal to minus 596.24 Newton. Simple thing is there. In this question, sum of horizontal is given. That's why in place of sum of horizontal, I wrote 400. Remaining thing as it is, remaining thing as it is, remaining thing as it is. After that, what you have to do? Bring the known terms at one side, unknown terms at another side. So, here this one is known, this one is known, means with the help of calci you can solve that value. So, this one is there, this one is there, this one is there. Only this one is the unknown is there. So, this, here it is carrying negative sign. If you shift it this side, it will become positive. And here it is carrying positive sign. If you shift that side, it will become negative. With the help of calci, with the help of simple calculator, if you solve this one, you will get the answer. You will get some P cos theta is equal to something. But here this one is also unknown, this one is also. When in any equation if two unknowns are there, so that one you have to consider as the equation 1. This one has to consider as the equation 1. Because here two unknowns are there. If one unknown will be there, you can consider, you can easily find out the value. But in this problem two unknowns are there. So let us assume the equation 1. Try to solve out the sum of vertical. For finding sum of vertical, for sum of vertical any value is not given. Whenever value is not given, by default you have to assume as 0. When you have to find out the any force or theta. So, first I have to calculate how many vertical forces are there. So, here 1, 2, 3, 4. This one also you have to consider. Why you didn't resolve this one? Because it is lying on the axis. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the sum of vertical. So, first I will write here, sum of vertical forces is equal to, what is the first force? 100 sine 30 degree. What is the second force? Plus P sine theta. What is the third force? Minus 100 sine 45. Minus 100 sine 45. What is the next force? Minus 100. Minus 100. As you can see here, this is x, this one is minus x, this is y, this one is minus y. We are finding sum of vertical. Sum of vertical means here y sign is negative. Here y sign is negative. So, minus 100. How much it will be? Minus 100. But in question anything is not given and you have to find out the value, so sum of vertical you have to assume as 0. This one if you assume 0, how much it will become? 100 sine 30 plus p sine theta minus 100 sine 45 minus 100 irrespective of the sine theta and cos theta. Why you are not considering that sine theta and cos theta? Because it is lying on the axis, it is lying on the axis. After that you have to see what is the unknown here. This one is the unknown and here it is carrying which sign? Positive sign. So let it be this one there only, bring all the term in another side, let it p sine theta here only. P sine theta is equal to, if you shift this one this side it will become minus 100 sine 30. This one if you shift this side it will become plus 100 sine 45, then it will become plus 100. Like this you have to separate that. After that what you have to do, p sine theta is equal to, with the help of Kelsey try to solve that one, minus 100 sine 30, 100 sine 45 plus 100. You will get answer something 332.84. Try to solve that one. If you are getting negative value, then you can message me. I will try to solve that one. Okay, na? So p sine theta is equal to 332.84. So this one you have to consider as the equation 2. This is your equation 1 and this one is your equation 2. But he is asking to find out the value of p and theta. He is asking to find out the value of what is p and what is theta. You have to find out the value of p and theta. For finding the value of p and theta, for finding the value of p and theta, what you have to do, you know the equation 1 as well as equation 2. Equation 1. So what you have to do, equation 2 divided by equation 1. What is the equation 2? P sin theta by p cos theta. What is the p sin theta value? P sin theta value 332.84. This is minus 596.24. This p will get cancelled. So tan theta is equal to minus 332.84 by 596.24. Neglect the sin theta. Tan theta is equal to, you solve this one, you will get the theta value. With the help of that, you will get the theta value 29.17. Theta value is 29.17. If you substitute that, like this you have to find. Whenever two unknown equations are there, what you have to do? This one you have to consider as equation 1 and this one you have to consider as equation 2. Try to find out the 2 divided by 1 or 1 divided by 2. If you take 2 divided by 1, here sin theta is there, here cos theta is there. So sin by cos will be tan and tan easily available in your calci. Even cot also you will get, inverse of tan you will get the cot. So better to take this one only. 2 divided by 1, p sin theta by p cos theta, you will get tan theta is equal to this one, theta is equal to tan inverse of this one. With the help of calci, if you solve this one, theta you will get 29.17. I told you how to find out the tan inverse. Shift tan, if you press, you will get the value of tan inverse. Shift tan, you will get the value of tan inverse. Like that you have to find out the theta value. After that he is asking to find out the value of p. For finding the value of p, in any of the equation you can substitute, you will get the value of p. So what I am doing, I am considering as the equation 2. What is my equation 2? Equation 2 is p sin theta is equal to 332.84. Here I have to substitute the theta value. P sin theta is equal to, theta value is how much? 29.17. That is 332.84. P is equal to 332.84 divided by sine 29.14. With the help of calci, if you solve this one, you will get the value. How much you will get the value of P? 682.82 Newton. Like this you will get the value of P. Like this you will get the value of P.
Now, in next problem, like this question will be given, diagram will be not given. So, whether it is this problem is related to if 2-4 or 3-4 or more than 3-4. If 2-4 are there, you can use the r is equal to under root of p square plus q square plus 2 p q cos theta, and tan theta is equal to q sin alpha by p plus q cos theta. Like this you have to, if 3-4 are given, you can use the Lamis theorem. With the help of Lamis theorem, easily you can find out. If more than 3-4 are given, then you have to use the resolution as previous problem. R is equal to under root of sum of horizontal forces plus sum of vertical forces, and tan theta is equal to modulo of sum of vertical by sum of horizontal. Like this you have to use. So here in this problem I wrote the question. So here what is given? Two locomotive on opposite banks of a canal pull a vessel having a parallel to the banks by means of a two horizontal rope. Okay, no? So here canal is there. This one is the. Here you can assume this one is the canal, and here locomotive is there, and here locomotive. This one you have to consider as the locomotive. Locomotive means shapes, any vehicle you have to consider. So in canal means you have to consider the given one is the shape only. So what you have to do? Two locomotive on opposite banks of a canal pull a vessel having a parallel to the banks by means of a two horizontal rope. The tension in these ropes are, see here two tensions are there. So this one you have to consider as the tension 1, and this one you have to consider as the tension 2. First one you have to consider as the tension 1, and second one you have to consider as the tension 2. So two tensions are there. How much first one is there? 2000. Second one is the 2400. So first one 2000 newton, and here 2400 newton. First one 2000 newton, second one 2400 newton. After that, what is given? While the angle between them is 60 degree, the angle between these two tension is equal to, from here to here, how much angle is given? 60 degree. The angle is equal to how much? 60 degree. Find the resultant. He is asking to find out the resultant. Find the resultant, and the angle between the each of the rope and the side of the canal means he is asking to find out the theta also. He is asking to find out the r value, and he is asking to find out the value of theta. So once again I will read. Two locomotive on opposite banks of the canal put a vessel moving parallel to the banks by means of a two horizontal rope. So this one you have to consider as the first horizontal rope, and this one you have to consider as the second horizontal rope. If for first horizontal rope, how much tension is given? 2000 newton. For second horizontal, how much tension is given? 2400 newton. And the angle between that two is equal to how much it is given? 60 degree. Angle is how much is given? 60 degree. You have to find out the resultant. Resultant means you have to find out the value of r, and you have to find out the value of theta. For finding these two value, what you have to do? First one you have to consider as the p. P is equal to how much? 2000 newton. And second one you have to consider as the q. Q is equal to how much? 2400 newton. You got the value of p and q. So here write down p value is equal to how much it is? 2000 newton. And q value is equal to how much? 2400 newton. And theta value is also given. Theta value is equal to how much? 60 degree. In this problem, diagram is not given, so you have to find out the diagram also. What is two locomotive of a opposite banks of a canal pull a vessel having parallel to the banks by means of a two horizontal rope? This is the first horizontal rope, and this one is the second horizontal rope. Two ropes are there. The tension in this ropes are 2000 and 2400. This is 2000 and this is 2400. 2000 and 2400 newton. The unit should be newton. And the angle is given between these two angle. How much it is given? 60 degree. Angle how much it is given here? 60 degree. Find the resultant pull by the vessel and the angle between the each rope and the side of the canal. And the side of the canals you have to find out. So what you have to do? P is given, Q is given, and theta is given. P is given, Q is given, and theta is given. Next step, what you have to do? Here how many forces are there? Two forces are there. Whenever two forces are there, you have to find out the magnitude and direction. For that, what you have to do? R is equal to under root of P square plus
square plus 2pq cos alpha
or theta, it's up to you. R is equal to under root of p square plus q square plus 2pq cos alpha.
Here you have to substitute under root of, what is the value of p? 2000 whole square. Q value is equal to 2400 whole square. Then 2 into p value is equal to how much? 2000 into 2400 into cos 60 degree. Try to solve this value in your calculator with the help of Kelsey. You will get some value here. R is equal to, I will write directly, 3815.76 Newton. This is the value of R.
R is equal to 2815.76 Newton. With the help of Kelsey, try to solve this one. 3815.76 Newton. This is the value of R. After that, you have to find out the value of theta.
Tan theta is equal to Q sin alpha by P plus Q cos alpha.
Tan theta is equal to Q sin alpha by P plus Q cos alpha. Tan theta is equal to Q sin alpha by P plus Q cos alpha. This is the formula for tan theta.
Substitute for finding the direction. This is the formula for finding the direction. For direction, you have to use this one. So, tan theta is equal to, Q value is how much? 2400. And alpha value is equal to how much? 60 degree. And P value is equal to how much? 2000. Q value is equal to how much? 2400. Theta value is equal to how much? 60 degree. Then tan theta is equal to, if you solve this one, theta is equal to tan inverse of this. Here you will get the value of theta.
Here you will get 27.33 degree. Like this you have to solve. Tan theta is equal to Q sin alpha by P plus Q cos alpha. So tan theta is equal to 2400 by sin 60 by 2000 into 2400 cos 60. Tan theta is equal to this. If you shifted here tan inverse of this one, then theta is equal to 27.33. Like this you will get the magnitude as well as the direction. So in this you have to identify whether the problem is related to two forces are given or three forces are given or more than three forces are given. I told you if two forces are given you can use the resultant and R is equal to under root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta and direction Q is equal to sin theta by P plus Q cos theta. If more than if three forces are given, you can use the Lamis theorem, that is P by sin alpha by Q by sin theta is equal to R by sin gamma. I will explain you that later, Lamis theorem. If three forces are given, how to find out? After that, what is given? If more than three forces are given, then you have to use the resolution. R is equal to under root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. R is equal to under root of sum of horizontal forces plus sum of vertical forces. Tan theta is equal to modulus of sum of vertical by sum of horizontal. In this question, it is not mentioned whether the problem is related to two forces, three forces or more than three forces. By reading the question, you have to identify whether the, and you have to draw this diagram also. Here, two locomotives on opposite banks of a canal pull a vessel moving parallel to the banks by means of a two horizontal rope. So, here one locomotive is there. This is the locomotive. Here two horizontal forces are there. This one is the horizontal force and this one is the horizontal force. The direction of flow is like this and it is moving like this. Here how much it is there? 2000 Newton. Here how much it is there? 2400 Newton. Here how much it is there? 2000 Newton. Here how much it is there? 2400 Newton. And between these two, how much angle is given? 60 degrees angle is given. Between these two, how much angle is given? 60 degree. He is asking to find out the resultant. How much it will move? Resultant means how much it will move to oppose that water. How much you have to find out the value of R and you have to find out the value of theta. Theta with respect to that angle. So you have to find out the value of R and you have to find out the value of theta. Let us assume first force you have to assume as P. P is equal to how much? 2000 Newton. And second force you have to assume as Q. Q is equal to how much? 2400 newton, and alpha you have to assume as 60 degree. Alpha is equal to how much? 60 degree. Alpha is equal to, after that what you have to do, you have to substitute here, r is equal to under root of p square plus q square plus 2pq. You know that the only two forces are there, so what you have to do, r is equal to under root of p square plus q square plus 2pq cos alpha. With the help of that you will get the resultant, and you have for the finding the direction, tan theta is equal to q sin alpha by p plus q cos alpha. With the help of that you will get the theta. Like that you, in this problem and in any problem, it will not mention whether the problem is related to two forces, three forces, or more than three forces. In next class we will see the other problem related to this topic only.